Sports. It's in the game.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give it to all what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
They gon' try to intrude, question the multitude. They be quick to accuse, when you got different views. Just know you gon' pay the price, based off the item you choose.
Monetizing the culture, hit you with MK Ultra. I knew you was a vulture, Holy Ghost get the ushers. No, I can't
push your
ushers. Caution, then I was cluttered, doing sort of rolling on through the rubber. Remember, it's a jungle, the top I was gonna get shot. In the middle, gotta stay hunting. Why the rush up for nothing? 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 Agitated.
Game over, time's up. Play my cards, dumb, my hand ain't really no time for luck. Either you got it, you don't. Lie to yourself if you won't. I put my team on my back. Did what I could, what I had. Now I'll be all in my bag. Copy and paste with the swag. Bet you can't do it like me. All my winnings on repeat. Take your L like a boss. Stand 10 toes on your feet. I can never take a loss. I ain't set up for defeat. 4 Giottos on the truck. I had a dream and it's stuck. Living my life cause we up. Looking back like where the love. So I be hella low key. But contrary to belief, loyalty runs deep. I keep my ear to the streets. Struggle turn me to a beast. I'm off the chain, I'm off the leash.
The NFL is on EA Sports, and we're at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, Florida. With the echoes of cannon blast still ringing in our ears from the north end zone, the Bucs were introduced a moment ago, and they are all set as their guys will do battle with the Green Bay Packers. Tampa. This one taken just inside the 10 and able to get this out to the 25.
First down 10 at their own 25 yard line.
Play clock down to zero, and this is not the way to start a drive. Offensive penalty has us back where we started as they come up on a first and 10. Out of the shotgun, it's Jones. And some room to maneuver. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive. First down.
First down, Green Bay.
And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4.
It's a pickup of 6. Brings up second.
Shotgun now for Rodgers. This one complete to Devin Funchess. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down. From the shotgun to give to Jones. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. 13 yards, first down, Packers.
gain of 13 yards. And the first down.
Now Jones. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 10 more there and another first down.
It's a gain of 10.
From the gun, it's Rodgers. And it's caught. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the one. The end result, 21 yards. Two. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Looks like they quit hitting the snooze button on their alarm there. Finally a sign of life from this defense. They've been fairly passive on this opening drive. Now able to stand up on first and goal, and they sent that play backwards.
Back at the two now, here's second and goal. They'll try and run it in with Jones. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Packers take it right down the field and score on the opening drive. On is Mason Crosby for the point after. It's good to make it 7-0 Packers.
Makes the score Packers 7, Buccaneers nothing.
What are you doing?
Mason Crosby to kick off for Green Bay.
Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Taken from about the 12.
The Bucs take over first and 10. At their own 21-yard line. Problems right out of the gate. We're going to get a delay.
Get ready, get ready, get ready.
And the offensive penalty has us back where we started as they come up on a first and 10. From the gun, it's Brady. His throw incomplete. Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. But it'll be second down. Charles, already trailing by a touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. But I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay.
Looking for Evans, and it's intercepted. Picked off around the 41. And into the end zone, it's a pick six and a Packer touchdown.
Mason Crosby for the extra.
We thought this defense would be opportunistic, and they were. Here, you're already up. Now you got a two-touchdown lead. I tell you, going out there on defense, did they have a little bit of extra momentum with a score already on the board?
Oh, without a doubt. That already felt good to them. They took it and used it and obviously put up another one. But here's the thing now. Some defense coordinators might want to pull their guys back a little bit because they don't want them to make mistakes because they're too over-amped. Others say, I've got 2-touchdown lead. Go get them, guys. They'll be even more aggressive.
Pulls it in at the 13. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25.
At their own 24-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they just had that pick six. I guess the only positive maybe of them returning that for a touchdown, this offense right back out onto the field to try to make up for it.
Because now it doesn't give them a chance to go to the bench and really settle. You know, to sit there and kind of seethe over the idea that they turned the ball over previously. Right back out there. It's almost like hopping right back on the bike after falling over. Let's see if they can get the ball moving again.
Yeah, we'll see if they can do it here. The throw down the field, caught by his running back. All the way inside the 15 before they drop it. The big gainer there on the catch and run, 37 yards. Well, make that now two completions for him on this drive, and these aren't ordinary completions, they're big ones.
Yeah, these are the types that make a secondary talk to each other and not in a good way. Oftentimes pointing fingers. Hey, who's got it? Someone cover it. That type of indecision can open up even more big plays.
And the Bucs are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
First and goal at the 3-yard line.
They'll try to punch it in with Fournette. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Back to the ground, this time with Jones. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Bucs are able to make this a close game again. A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up. Meaning, when you get on a guy, you just stay right there. Each guy has his own assignment that allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
And here's Lewis. And he'll be out of bounds across the 25.
At their own 28-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
So now they'll come up on 2nd and 10, once again from the 28. Toss left side into the hands of his tight end. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 12 yards there and a first down. Off the play fake to Jones. Here's Rodgers. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A very solid gain of 27.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
Rodgers now on first down. Out of the backfield, this is Aaron Jones. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. And again, it's Rodgers. Looking for his tight end on the corner. It's complete. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. Rodgers to throw once more. On the right side, this is Austin with a catch. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. A gain of 13, it's a first down. Rodgers again now. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's 2nd down.
It's a gain of 7. Brings up 2nd and 3.
Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the 2. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on 3rd and 2. They'll try and run for it with Jones. And Jones is not going to have the first down as they stop him short. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up 4th down.
It's now 4th down.
We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have highlights and analysis of this first half of action. They'll run it with Jones. And this time, he is in.
Yes, I can hear you.
Aaron Jones with his 2nd touchdown here in this first half. And the Packers add 6 to their lead. It's good, and it is now 21-7.
Makes the score, Packers 21, Buccaneers 7.
Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. And this will make it into the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
The Bucs take over 1st and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good. And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Darnell Savage. We don't see this often. A quarterback of his caliber, 2 first half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is his horoscope off? His biorhythms? What is it?
You went horoscope on us, David.
Well, I was thinking maybe REM sleep was off.
I'm trying to come up with something. Anything, right? And out of bounds.
Yeah, ayy, I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this, ayy, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this, ayy, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this, ayy, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this, ayy, turn the knob, can't resist, I'm incredible, yeah, came for the dollars, call it vegetable, then I did the dash, can I catch me, bro, ooh, then I did the dash, can I catch me, whoa, your whole team is no competition, boy, I did it by myself, it's a solo mission. I'm a fool, dog. Turn the whole field to a schoolyard. Bunch of students ain't eating around here. I'm the GOAT, little man, and I made it loud and clear. Put the gas on them like I'm with the Cavalier. Show no love, got the confidence, no fear. I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this.
The NFL is on EA Sports, and we're at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, Florida. Just a short time ago, the Buccaneers emerging from their tunnel to the roar of this frenzied crowd here in the Sunshine State. And we're in the big ship, and fittingly, everyone here ready to do battle as Tampa Bay gets ready to match up with the Green Bay Packers.
Thank you.
has the punter Bradley Pinion on to get us started. And off we go from Tampa. And here's Lewis. And he's going to get this across the 20 as he's out of bounds at the 23.
They're on the 23-yard line.
Down to zero, and this is not the way to start a drive. And the offensive penalty has us back where we started as they come up on a first and 10. Jones, and this one goes nowhere, losing yardage back at the 22. It'll go as a loss of a yard on the game's first play. Second down. This is Jones, and he finds some space past the 25 to the 27. This defense looking for an early stop. This is third down and 6. He's going to find his man. That's Tavon Austin. And he is going to have a Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here. And this winds up a pickup of 2, maybe 2.5 to about the 39.
A gain of 2 brings up 7 and 8.
From the 39, Rodgers. He gets this to Devontae Adams. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
First down, Green Bay.
First down, Rodgers. The left side throw complete to Adams. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. They go right back to him for 20 and a first. Now a first down carry by Jones. And some room to work. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Aaron Jones, 29 yards. And the Packers take it right down the field and score on the opening drive. Boy, I tell you what, when you get a running back who can move like that in the open field, that's something to take advantage of, and they certainly did there.
Mason Crosby to kick off for Green Bay.
Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. A short kick taken at the 18. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20.
At their own 18-yard line.
Now's the time. Don't give him nothing.
Brady going to bring the Bucs up with a first and 10 at their own 18. And now a timeout coming from the defensive side for the Packers. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Seaman, and he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Adrian Amos up to make the tackle.
Second and 10 at the 17-yard line.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Shotgun now for Brady. And a first hookup with his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. A gain there of 21 yards. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Brady going to fake the give to Jones and set up to throw. He's got it complete to Gronkowski. And he'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. Give him 32 on the play.
The 30-yard line.
Working from the gun, it's Brady. Looking for Gronkowski, and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 26. There goes Green. He's at the 30. 10. And into the end zone. It's a pick six and a Packer touchdown.
Mason Crosby for the extra point.
And this defense looking like they have come to play the pick six. And just like that, it's 13-0 early on.
Well, go back with me to our training camp visits. What do we hear during these drills? Pass. Ball. Ball's in the air.
And then my favorite.
Oski. That's the interception. That means everybody find someone to block. Block them legally. Stay on your feet. And they get it done. Touchdown.
And a short kick taken at about the 16. And he'll be stopped up at the 25.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play too.
Looking back to the air on second down, it's Brady. This into the hands of his running back, Ronald Jones. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 19 yards the pick up there. Move the chains.
First and 10 at the 44-yard line.
Throwing on first down is Brady. Left side completion to Jones. He's going to get this all the way down inside the 35.
Come on, let's go.
23 yards the final tally.
Buccaneers first down. First and 10 at the 30.
On play action. Now Brady. Gronkowski got it. Crossing route. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Now Brady again. And he's going to be dropped. 15-yard line. Dean Lowry just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7.
Well, that was point counterpoint, wasn't it? They decided to throw for it on first and goal. Instead, the defense counters with pressure, and the defense wins, getting a big sack.
After the sack on first down, Brady. Back of the end zone. Could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
Interested to see what they dial up here. Third and goal with a lot of green between them and the end zone. From the gun, Brady. And this is going to be intercepted. Kevin King with a pick. And a short return will be stopped inside the 10 at the 8-yard line. No doubt, a very disappointing end to what was a pretty strong opening drive.
They had 3 points in their back pocket. It was there for them. If you don't like what you see, just throw it away. Make sure you get those points on the board. Don't get too greedy.
And it's intercepted in the end zone. Right at the end, it's picked. Well, it's not every day you see a defense pick the ball off and already have 6 points without moving.
And on that play, no distance to run. Similar play, although it didn't happen right in the end zone, but you remember that Washington-Los Angeles Super Bowl? Where Joe Theismann tried to throw the screen pass. I can't remember the number, but he tried to throw the screen pass and Jack Squatter got it with no one around and just waltzed in and pretty much broke their backs. That's a similar play, although this one didn't have to run at all.
Here we go. Stats guy Johnny on the spot. Super Bowl 18, 38-9. It was in Tampa. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Now Rodgers to try again after the pick six. Got a man, it's Tanyan complete. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. A gain of 32 that time.
But they didn't ease into that drive right out of the turnover. They go for the big shot downfield and hit it. A lot of teams have that opportunity, but not every coach is going to green light that type of a play call. I love their aggressiveness.
So the big play gets them across midfield now for first and 10. Before they're inside the 25. Another first down, this time on a gain of 19. On play action, Rodgers eluding the pressure right. And he's going to keep it here. And he's out of bounds, almost gets to the 10. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down. The last drive, remember, similar situation. He forced a ball into coverage through the pick. He learned better there.
Yeah, similar to a golfer that's confronted with a shot that you just can't make. Sometimes you have to take your medicine, as they say, right? Just pull it down, take off, and go. Don't make something worse than what it was.
Down. It's Jones. And a pickup of about four down inside the 10 to the 8 yard line. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Here's Jones. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage.
Steve McClendon.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. And he's got it. It's caught for a Packers touchdown. It's Devontae Adams hauling it in from Aaron Rodgers. And the Packers add on to their lead. Well, that's about as quick of a passing touchdown as you'll ever see right there.
Everyone has a section in their playbook called the quick game. That was a super quick game. Out of the hands of the thrower, bam, right to the receiver, successfully for a touchdown.
How in-depth is that quick game part of the playbook?
It's pretty in-depth because people want the ball in the hands of the quarterback into the playmaker's hands downfield as fast as possible. There are a lot of plays, a lot of options involved with that.
And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27.
At the 27-yard line.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. To this point, the results have not been good. Two possessions, two turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball, try and get things settled down a little bit.
A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report. But business to take care of before we get there.
A two-minute drill before the coaches. Two-minute drill.
And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down. Operating from the gun, Brady. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. Not what they had in mind there. That's going to go as a loss of four. Brady going to find Jones here out of the backfield. Give him eight on the play, and that's going to bring up the third down. Brady gives this one off to Jones. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. Now the Bucks going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. After the run by Jones, here's first and 10. From the gun, it's Brady. And he hauls in for the Buccaneer touchdown. Tom Brady hooking up with Mike Evans there. And the Bucks have made this a one-score game.
Everyone in the league talks about finishing, don't they? Doesn't matter whether it's a quarter, a half, a game, a series, whatever. But they're finishing the first half in fine style, putting that one in the end zone.
They did. They didn't leave much time on the clock either. Well done. Boy, they're down only one score. It's still first half, but they're going to line up for the onside kick. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And here's Lewis. And he'll be out of bounds across the 25.
First and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead. But a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
Second and 10 now from the 27. Play action. Now Rodgers. He's got his tight end on the corner route. It's complete. 22 yards there. A first down.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius. Understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball. And puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup. They fake the give. Now Rodgers. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. Robert Tonyan was the one he was looking for, and that'll bring up second down.
I like the thought process there. They connected on a big play, and sometimes you find the defense vulnerable. So they went for the bigger shot, went for it all on that one. This time, they were ready for it.
Rodgers again here on second and 10. Now look out, Rodgers lost the football. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. And now they'll take a timeout defensively. After the second down play, they burn the timeout, making them sweat out the final few ticks here in the second quarter. And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle. And the lead works its way up to 10, 24-14. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. 2 quarters down. 2 still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. So this a 2-possession ball game as we get back underway, set for the third quarter. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he returns this to the 22.
On the return, the Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. Really nice of a drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush, pass rush, pass rush. Whether it's the guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the football.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here. Brady now on first down. That's complete to his running back, Evans. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. Looking for his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski, but it's going to be second down. To throw again, Brady. He'll drop this underneath for Jones. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the three. That one good for 17 yards, and now they've got it first and goal. Now Jones. And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
From the two now, second and goal. This time it's Fournette, and I think they stopped him again. They did at the one-yard line. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a third and goal. Here's Fournette, and this is going to depend on the spot, but I believe he might be a few inches short. It'll be called a gain of two, and that'll leave him with some options here on fourth and inches. Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth. And Brady will sneak it. Try to wedge his way in there. No signal. I don't think he got there. He didn't. They try the sneak, but not enough push. He doesn't get in. And instead of having a one-score game, they'll remain two scores down. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had a field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
Flushed out right. He's going to take off with it. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir. Able to turn that into a positive game. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 12 yards there and a first down.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try to put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. 25 yards, the pickup there, and also a first down. Working from the gun, Rodgers. Over the middle, that's caught by Adams. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. This game not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Here's Rodgers throwing quickly to the flat. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. It's Devontae Adams hauling it in from Aaron Rodgers. And the Packers are able to stretch that lead out further. Had the option to hand that one off or run it himself, but instead, a really easy, quick pass.
I like the way they made a decisive decision and got it right to the receiver. One move later, he's in the end zone.
Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. And a short kick taking it about the 16. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further.
Take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it on a fourth down try. But they had to like the feeling that they had going out offense. They want to continue to see if they can capture that again on this drive and maybe get in the same position.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, like I said, they were moving the football. It's not like they went four and out, so I don't think it's a deal where the offense doesn't have confidence.
No, I agree with you totally on that one. If anything, they may have gained more confidence. Okay, they stopped us once. That's all right. Let's keep moving it. Make them do it again.
Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Jones. 15 more yards there, and quickly another first down.
That's a 48-yard line.
Brady now on first down. And incomplete there, almost picked off. That's one you maybe expect your roaming free safety to come up with. But it's second down. Throwing again, Brady. Again for Evans. This time he's got him. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 23. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Tom Brady to his old Patriot pal, Rob Gronkowski. And the Bucs are able to cut in out of that deficit.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury, and it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run and he finds himself open for an easy touchdown.
Extra point put through by Succop, and the lead is trimmed down to 10.
Bradley Pinion to kick off for Tampa Bay.
Now Pinion with a kickoff honors following the touchdown. And here's Lewis. And he's going to be out of bounds on the return. Not a great return. They'll start back around the 17.
They're on 17-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. If they can score here, they have a chance to make this a three-possession game and all but put things to bed. Levante David in on the tackle. You know, I was going to ask you if maybe they should surprise and pass the ball, but where they're at on the field, I think keep it on the ground, right?
I like where you're going with this one because field position is going to determine these play calls. And backed up where they are, I don't even think about putting the ball in the air. I tell my running backs, grasp the football, and I tell my offensive line, don't allow any leaks so they get hit immediately when we hand it off.
That's going to set him back 5 yards. And it looks like this will be the last play before the two-minute warning. Rodgers to throw on second down. Over the middle, complete. It's Adams. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. Down under 2 minutes to go in this football game. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. And no doubt what they're looking to do is just salt away the final couple of minutes and escape with a win. To throw is Rodgers. He'll let it fly for Austin. Defense loses him. It's complete. Touchdown, Packers! Tavon Austin, 60 yards! Rodgers. And the Packers add 6 to their lead. Even later into his career now, there aren't too many guys that can launch it downfield with accuracy better than Aaron Rodgers.
And as that ball was hanging in the air with the receiver streaking downfield to meet it, here in the stadium, you could just sense the crowd thinking, oh no! And their worst fears were realized as that one turned into a long touchdown.
And the Buccaneers able to recover. Their hands team does its job. Fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Gronkowski, the intended receiver, and it's second down. Shotgun, it's Jones. And he's corralled at the 40, but not before picking up 8.
He's tackled at the 40-yard line.
Brady looking to throw on 3rd and 2. Looking for Gronkowski, and he's got it complete. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line.
First and 10 at the 20.
On first down, Brady. And that will be caught, but out of the end zone, says the field judge. It's ruled incomplete. Evans once again, the intended receiver. And now it's second down. To throw again, Brady. That is caught inside the 5. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the 1. An excellent pickup of 20 yards. Trying to run for it with Fournette. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. Brady's going to sneak it. And he is not going to get in as the big bodies stop him at the 1. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
The ball down at the 1 as they come up after the penalty on another 2nd and goal. And he stopped immediately there. Officially, no gain on the sneak. Kind of a wasted play there, and now it's 3rd down.
I know they didn't get it, but I kind of like the call. 2nd and inches, go right to the quarterback sneak. Normally, that should be executed better, shouldn't it?
I'm going to disagree with you. I don't like the call.
You don't like that?
Just because they didn't get it, though. Oh, okay. Hindsight's 20-20.
20-20 and never defeated.
And now with 4 seconds left, we get a timeout call. Field goal doesn't help. They're going to go for the 6 here on 4th and goal. They'll go with Jones. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown. Deficit. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go.
Let me go ahead and show my age a little bit. I liked it when they would fake it from the 3-yard line, right? When they'd line up, go ahead, and oh, there's a fake, and he's going to get 2. That's great. But from the 15, the risk reward. just not there.
It's so risky to get 15 yards on a fake. Oh, you see the result right there.
Yeah, I know these young whippersnappers are trying to do different things in this game, but let's go back to old reliable. Kick the ball through the post.
Get off my lawn.
That's darn right.